ARKit can't tell you if a person is good or evil yet, but it can turn your eye device into an augmented reality machine. It gathers real-world input from your eye device's camera and other sensors, evaluates that input through the ARKit API, combined with the code that you write to make use of that API, and finally, it uses that evaluation to augment real-world images with virtual computer-generated images. This course covers ARKit 2.0, which comes with iOS 12, and it's the framework's third release. Each release added a new suite of features, but for the purposes of this course, each release brought one big new thing to ARKit. ARKit 1.0 was introduced with iOS 11 and brought basic features that we'll cover today, being able to draw virtual images over real-world ones and being able to detect real-world horizontal planes. With ARKit 1.5, which came out with the iOS 11.3 update, it brought two new goodies to the table: the ability to detect real-world vertical planes and the ability to recognize specified real-world flat 2D images, such as photographs, paintings, book covers, signs, and so on. ARKit 2.0 added the ability to recognize specified real-world 3D objects. Doing AR requires a fair bit of processing power, the kind that only later models of eye devices can provide. You'll need an eye device with an A9 processor or later. That means, for iPhones, you need a 6S or later. And for iPads, any iPad Pro will support ARKit, and so will any iPad without the Pro from 2017 or later. You may also find that a nice long lightning cable, either at least 6 feet or 2 meters, depending on the measuring system you like, will come in handy. In addition to the hardware requirements, you'll need the following: iOS 12 or later on your eye device, Xcode 10 or later on your development Mac, the readiness to walk about and wave your eye device as you do so, the willingness to do at least a little 3D math — don't worry, we'll help you with that — and finally, because AR is a constantly evolving field, the patience to deal with constant changes and upgrades. One of the interesting things about ARKit is that it doesn't provide you with just one option for drawing virtual computer-generated images over the real-world images provided by the camera. You get three. First, you get SpriteKit, which is Apple's 2D graphics framework for games and animations. Then there's Metal, Apple's low-level hardware-accelerated 3D graphics and shaders framework for hardcore graphics programming. And finally, there's the one we're going to use in this course, SceneKit. That's Apple's high-level framework for creating 3D animated scenes and effects. If you've done SpriteKit programming, you will find SceneKit familiar. In this section of the course, we'll build an app called Hello AR World, which will introduce you to two different but related things. First, the basics of building augmented reality apps with ARKit, and second, the basics of drawing 3D images with SceneKit. That's right, you're not just getting an ARKit course, you're also getting a SceneKit crash course.
Augmented reality is a fascinating technology that allows us to mix a little bit of the virtual world with the real world. Of course, there's a lot more to it than that, so subscribe to this channel and tap that notification bell to be alerted when new videos on AR are released.